scene is from a part of the Lemmings Theory Chapter 2, which we rotoscoped and shot through a mobile phone. The character goes into a dream sequence, and I wanted to basically have the character going out of the house without actually going out of the house himself, literally. In the script I wanted it to be like someone's kind of painting the images on the screen while they're coming up, or drawing the images on the screen. I wanted it to look very, very kind of lagged. It's kind of like stop motion. Rotoscoping itself, anyone who does that knows that it can take literally like months to actually rotoscope something, and we didn't have that kind of time, so we were trying to come up with ideas on how we can kind of express this dream sequence without spending day by day going through each drawing. It may seem really strange to some people why we want to shoot on a mobile phone, obviously that being such a compressed camera format, but it actually had loads of positives to it, and one of them, the main one being, lower a frame rate to something like 12 or 15 frames a second, or even 19 frames a second. It just kind of meshes together. If you move it too fast, it becomes blurred, and that kind of worked perfectly for this part of the film. To actually create the animation itself, what we did was Alex had an app on his phone which kind of filters out a lot of the image and kind of makes it look a bit drawn out. Some videos we shot through the program and they look like I said, washed out, pencil-like, and some we shot clean for visual effects and compositing later on. Once I then brought it into post, I added a whole bunch of effects to it, and then I exported that as an image sequence at 20 frames a second, and so I then imported that into Photoshop, and frame by frame I then just kind of traced the detail that I had already in the video images and then added more detail in. Sometimes shots wouldn't match together 100%, so I'd go back and film like something in the middle. For instance, the opening shot of the animation sequence, there is Francis laying on the bed. Camera pans up from his eye and then shifts round to him at the bookshelf. The shift didn't work too great, so I ended up just splicing in a kind of a small few frames of a kind of a cat, just meshing together and forming a cat, and then going into that character. So the end of the dream sequence comes to its kind of climax. He doesn't want to conform and be the same as everyone else, and unfortunately the system in his dream is just constantly surrounding him, and there's nothing he can do to escape it. And eventually, actually through like a visual kind of style, we decided stickmen would be appropriate, and they're going to basically catch up to him, and he's going to be a part of their system, their plan. For that particular shot, I didn't have a clue really how we were going to film it to start with. I was thinking, well, we'll go there, I'll explain it to the actor, I'll explain it to Alex, and we can film it. Kind of give him the impression that things are going to fall on him, and then just maybe hope that he reacts in a way where it looks like a big giant stick man is actually landing on him. And finally, when I kind of said to Alex, like, I wanted to think about stickman, he was like, oh, I'll see if I can just knock it up in a cinema 4D, and that just worked perfectly. There's loads of edits we're working on, and there's loads more stuff we can show you, so we'll post more as we get them finished and as we bring them in.